traffic, India Hotel, India, at the Southern Hangar, Cromwell Racecourse, shortly to lift. We'll lift and take off runway 09. Initially, we'll be over Cromwell Town, and then we'll be climbing for the Pisa Range. Any other traffic, Cromwell? Okay, let's go flying. As we take off from here, just over on my left hand side there, that's our mountain biking rack. We can put up to 12 mountain bikes in that. We take the mountain bikes up the top of the hill, and the mountain bikers get to enjoy a nice ride down the hill. Cornwall traffic, India Hotel, India's rolling, runway 09. As we take off from here, out on our left hand side is the horse racing track in Cornwall. And out ahead of us is first the industrial part of Cromwell, and then beyond is Cromwell Town itself. As we head out this way, we're just going to head over the motorcycle track ahead of us, and out to the right of that is the Schaefer Beetle Reserve. This is an area that is set aside purely for the sake of a beetle. The beetle itself is deaf and blind, and only comes out at night. Looked after by the Department of Conservation, and the hope is that the numbers will be maintained or increased. As we come up here, we can now begin to see Lake Dunstan ahead of us. Lake Dunstan is a man-made lake. It was formed when they built the Clyde Dam, and the Clyde Dam is located 22 kilometres down through the Cromwell Gorge, which we'll shortly be able to see down into over on the right-hand side there. The lake itself is fed by two rivers, the Karawa River coming in from Lake Wakantipu behind us, coming down from Queenstown, and then from the north the Clutha River, which drains Lake Wanaka. When they started flooding the lake 25 years ago, they needed to move some of the buildings in Cromwell up out of the way of the water. They did that just ahead of us, and now that forms the old town, or the old precinct of Cromwell, and it's located just in front of us. There's some lovely old history there and some lovely cafes. Worth a visit. Just off the point on the right-hand side, they flooded the original bridge and then built us the new bridge further ahead. Up on our right is Northburn Station. It rises up to Leaning Rock all the way up the top there. Northburn's one of the largest sheep stations in the area. Just coming up over the golf course. The golf course is a Lynx golf course, so that means it's built on sand. Quite rare this far inland. Across to our left hand side we've got the ball over there, and out the front of the ball is the big fruit display. Big fruits is meant to signify Cromwell's a great place to grow stone fruit. Having a bit of a tidy up around that at the moment, should be looking a bit better in a couple of weeks time. And across the road from that is the Wooing Tree Vineyard. So as we track up the lake here, we look out the right hand side into the very far distance, big mountains you can see there, the St. Bathurst Range, and to the left hand side of that is where the Lindis Pass is. The Lindis Pass is the highest pass on the New Zealand Roading Network. At the top end of the lake on the right hand side is Bendigo Station, and Bendigo Station is perhaps best known for having Shrek the sheep. Shrek was found up high in Bendigo, been hiding away in a cave, and when they sheared him, he achieved the world record for the most amount of fleece. They then used Shrek as a mascot for Cure Kids, and in that role he was put in a helicopter and he was flown off to an iceberg that happened to be drifting past Dunedin at the time, and given another shearing on that. Just in front of us now is Loburn. Loburn also used to have a bridge across the River Clutha, and when they flooded the lake they tied a car to that bridge. The car is still on the bridge underneath the water. Go to YouTube, there's a very good video of somebody swimming around that particular car. Loburn and Bridge. We're just about to cross over the 45th parallel, and that means that we're exactly midpoint between the South Pole and the equator, and that line runs just underneath us shortly. Up on the lake, on the left-hand side of the lake, up on our right there, is Pisa Moines. That has a heritage boutique hotel down there. Also the Moines restaurant located down there. And then the main road runs up, and on each side of the main road there's several of the well-known Central Otago vineyards. Not very important in Central Otago, the Pinot Noir. So we're climbing up to the Pisa or Pisa ranges of the locals call them. They rise up to 6,500 feet. Get a great deal of snow in the winter time, and they use extensively for activities like langlaufing, Nordic skiing, cross-country skiing from the other side. We take snowshoeing trips up to the top, and there are dogs with sledges also operating at the top. What has become quite popular on windy days is kite skiing at the top these days as well. Top of the Pisa ranges is public land. It's administered by the Department of Conservation, and we have to apply and then we pay for all of our landing sites at the top. Below that land and ahead of us is Pisa Station, and out to the left of us is Lowburn Station, big sheep stations. Merino sheep. Merino sheep give up their wool for the icebreaker product. Climb up, looking out the left hand side now, we can just begin to see the top of the Remarkables poking ahead up there. Beyond that is where Queenstown is located. Once we get up towards the ridgeline, we will be able to see further west, and we'll be able to see all the mountains ahead of us. Today we should be able to see Mount Cook. Just waiting for it to appear on the horizon. It'll be out on our right hand side, just beyond the mountains that we can see. And that's about 160 kilometres to the north of us. See Mount Cook now, it's beyond the ranges out to our right hand side, beyond the two there. 160 odd kilometres to the north of us, out on the right hand side. So not far from our landing sites, as we track in, you can see Mount Aspiring now, just so we can get a bit higher. I'll talk more about the mountains over there on the second part of the flight. I just need to run through the safety brief for the landing. Once we land, it just takes me a short while just to secure the controls of the helicopter. And whilst I'm securing the controls of the helicopter, I'll ask that you guys swap those headsets, the aviation headsets, for the ear defenders. Most helpful if you could hang the headsets up. Then importantly, please wait for me to come round to the doors. I need to be the only one opening and closing doors. And once out of the helicopter, please remember that we have the rotor blades turning above our heads, so please don't stick anything up in the air. Once clear of the helicopter, please remain clear of the helicopter. I've got some hot chocolate, so I'll make the hot chocolate, so come get a hot chocolate off me. And then we'll have about 10 minutes or so to enjoy the scenery up here and take some photographs. I will be running around photographing everybody. Please smile or pose for the camera. Once I've done that, I'll head back to the helicopter. And when you see me at the helicopter with the doors open, I'd appreciate it if you make your way back to the aircraft at that point so that we can continue on the second part of the flight without too much of a delay.
Low rotor.
About 4 degrees outside and a little bit of wind, so yeah. Okay, if you'd like to swap those headsets across the ear defenders, then just wait for me to come out of the doors.